Subscribe to TechMT by clicking the subscribe button and tap on the bell icon to get all my latest awesome tech video updates.
Hello YouTube, this is Praveen for TechMT. In this video, I'll be showing you the top iPhone X tips and tricks that are worth knowing. I request you to watch the video till the end to know the most important privacy settings that you must change right now. And please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel if you find this video useful. So without any further ado, let's get started.
First one here in the list is enabling virtual home button. As we all know that after the release of iPhone X, there is no physical home button as we have in our previous iPhone models. If you would like to have the same experience, you can enable the virtual home button by going to Settings, then General, then Accessibility, and here we have Assistive Touch. You just need to enable and toggle the long press option and choose Home. You will now see the Assistive Touch icon on the screen and just press on it for the home button operation. This is not just as fast as swiping up from the bottom to move to home screen, but worth knowing. The second one is fixing the Face ID issues. Generally, iPhone X will tend to know the facial changes regularly. So it is rare to get the failure attempts when you try to unlock the smartphone using Face ID. But you can change few options if you use thick sunglasses all the time that iPhone X can't recognize your attention. So you need to change the security level in this case. To do this, open Settings, then General, then Accessibility, then choose Face ID and Attention, and here turn off the required attention for Face ID. From now, it just identifies the shape of your face to unlock the iPhone X using the Face ID. Third one here in the list is Reachability. Reachability for iPhones is a useful feature to easily access the top of your screen. For some reason, Apple has its Reachability feature turned off by default for the iPhone X, but it's quite handy to have turned on even if you don't use it a ton. To turn on Reachability on iPhone X, head to Settings, then General, and then tap on Accessibility. And here find the Reachability and toggle the button to turn it on. Now on the home screen, Reachability will activate if you start your swipe at about the middle of the icons on the dock. With the Reachability feature, you can even access the control center and notification screen easily by swiping down from the top. And of course, you need a bit of practice to master it. Fourth is knowing the battery percentage. With the iPhone X, you don't see the battery percentage indicator at the status bar because of the notch. But there are three ways to check the battery percentage of the iPhone X and click on this card to know more about it. But to quickly see the battery percentage, just swipe down from the right top to see the juice left in an iPhone X. Fifth one is customizing the control center. There is a much space left at the bottom of the control center to add some useful toggles. Do you know that there are many toggles available apart from these controls? Let me show you how you can add hidden control center toggles right here in just few seconds. Open Settings, then move to Control Center and choose Customize. Here you'll see all the available toggles, and to add them, just tap on the green plus icon and the particular control will be added to the control center. To remove, tap on the red icon to delete from the control center. Let me add the screen recording for now, and that's it. Just swipe down from the control center and tap on the record button to screen record the iPhone X. Sixth one is recording the long Animoji. Animojis are fun, really fun. But there are some limitations, like you can only send them through the iMessage and can record only for about 10 seconds. But yes, you can save them as a video file and can send via WhatsApp. Here's a video to know how you can send Animoji through WhatsApp. But how you can record a long Animoji? Let me show you how. I assume that you added the screen recording toggle to the control center by using the fifth tip, and now just swipe down the control center, then tap on the screen record. Now open the iMessage app, then compose an Animoji video with unlimited time. Yes, until you run out of space. You can edit the recorded video through the iMovie and can send to anyone without any issues. Try it now. Seventh one is sending an Animoji reaction as a sticker. You should smash that like button down below the video if you don't know about this. Not only the recorded video, but you can send the Animoji expression as a sticker. To send, open the iMessage and choose Animoji, then freeze your expression. Now long press on the an emoji and drag and drop on the message. You can't drop it in the empty space as it is an expression to the particular message. Cool, isn't it? Eighth one is 3D touch on the control center toggles. Do you know that you can force touch on the control center toggles to expand more options? Take your smartphone and try it now. 3D touch on every toggle available to see the hidden options. You can enable or disable AirDrop, personal hotspot, night shift or true tone. You can increase or decrease the intensity of the torchlight, calculator, camera, screen record, music, etc. Ninth one is restricting the control center on the lock screen. We have an option to access the control center if the phone is locked. What if someone took your smartphone and turned on the airplane mode? You don't receive calls or even can't connect to Find My iPhone as the mobile data will turn off automatically when the airplane mode is on. They will have access to all the options available at the control center. So, you need to secure it, right? To do that, open Settings, then Face ID and Passcode, enter the unlock password and come all the way down, then turn off the control center. From now, only the authorized people can have access to the control center. 10th one, moving all apps together. I personally love this option as I organize every single app into the respective folder. Moving single app every time is a bit annoying as they move too fast when switching between the screens. So if you are the one like me, then you should definitely check this feature. Long press on the icon until you see this cross and just move the app you hold. When you move the app, you won't see the cross icon at the edge. Now tap on the icons that you'd like to move till they come together. That's it. Take those icons to any screen and leave the finger. They will stay there till you move again. Simple, isn't it? 11th one, switching between the apps. The iPhone X is for gestures because we don't have the physical home button. If you think switching the apps is a difficult task on iPhone X, then you are wrong. Once you figure out how to switch apps without double clicking a button, you will never want to go back. Just swipe up from the bottom of the screen and hold it for a second. There you'll see all the apps and you can tap on the required one easily. But wait, this is not the one I would like to say. You just need to swipe left or right at the bottom exactly on the line you see to easily switch between the apps. Really easy. 12th one, closing the running apps. Like switching apps, you need to swipe up from the bottom and hold it for a second. Now again, hold on app window until you see the red icon at the top left of each app window. You can either swipe up or tap on the red one to close the app. Which one do you feel convenient? Let me know through the comment section. 13th one, take screenshot on iPhone X. This is really simple. Just hold the side button as we know it as power button and press the volume up button. Once again, hold the side button and press the volume up button. You can edit and save the screenshot like you need. 14th one, night shift. It allows you to enable your iPhone to automatically adjust the colors in your display based on night and day. To activate, open Settings, then Display and Brightness, then choose Night Shift. Turn on the scheduled and change to sunset to sunrise. You can even opt to custom schedule. Also, you'll have the control over the color temperature. When the night shift is on, your phone automatically adjusts the display so that it gives off warmer, less blue light which doesn't affect your sleep. 15th one, reduce brightness. Do you know that you can reduce the brightness of the screen of iPhone X even less than you have now? This one is pretty handy when you read a lot in night times. You can even save the battery by activating it. Let me show you how you can enable this reduce brightness option. Open Settings, then General, then Accessibility, then Display Accommodations, and here turn on the reduce white point, then choose the intensity. The more you go, the lesser the intensity will be. Night shift plus reduce brightness option is a killer combination if you love reading or watching movies at night. Just play with it. 16th one, Rise to Wake. In iPhone X, we have this option to enable. To activate, go to Settings, then Display and Brightness, and here turn on the Rise to Wake. You don't need to press any other buttons to turn on the display, to check the notifications, or to unlock the screen. Just raise your iPhone X and it will turn the display on. I don't actually enable it because when I hold and walk with the iPhone X, it keeps turning on the device because the iPhone is moving. Alternatively, we have Tap to Wake feature on iPhone X. Simple and simple. 17th one, watch the videos in full screen. Because of the notch, the videos you play on iPhone X will have the empty blank spaces on either side. You can either stretch the video if you use the default player on iPhone X, or you can pinch in the video if you are watching through YouTube. But note, you'll definitely miss some parts of the video for sure. 18th one, camera picture format. This is important. You should know about this. There are two formats available in iPhone X. One is high efficiency, which is a new one, with HEIF format for pictures and HEVC format for videos. The second is the most compatible, like JPEG. When you opt for high efficiency, the picture quality will remain same and the size will be lower than JPEG. So it's up to you whether to choose high efficiency or most compatible. To change the format, open Settings, then Camera, then Formats, and here pick the one as per your liking. 19th one, enable HDR. When you open the camera app, you won't see the HDR control option like we usually have in our previous iPhone models. In iPhone X, it was already enabled by default. So every picture you take will now have HDR. If you would like to control the HDR manually, you need to turn off the Auto HDR mode. To do this, go to Settings, then Camera, and turn off the Auto HDR. You will now have the HDR option within the camera app. You can control it whenever you need. 20th one, enable 4K at 60 frames per second. To change, open Settings, then Camera. To record a 4K video at 60 frames per second, you first need to change the format to high efficiency and then opt for 4K at 60fps option. 21st one, scanning QR codes. Gone are those days where we need to download QR code scanning apps to find something. And now just open the iPhone X camera and try to scan the QR code. You'll see the details about it instantly. Cool, isn't it? 22nd one, Wi-Fi Assist. Nothing too fancy. Enable this option to automatically switch to cellular data when you have a poor Wi-Fi connection. To turn this on, open Settings, then Mobile Data, then here come all the way down and toggle the Wi-Fi Assist. That's it. From now, when you have the poor Wi-Fi connection, this option will let you use cellular data automatically. I recommend you to avoid this if you have less cellular data. 23rd one, turn off Bluetooth. In iPhone X or iOS 11, you can't totally turn off the Wi-Fi or Bluetooth from the control center. These options will turn back on when you invoke something like turning on the Bluetooth device you already paid, etc. This will drain the battery soon, and we recommend to turn the Bluetooth off permanently by going through Settings, then Bluetooth, and here toggle the button. You can turn this on easily from the control center when you require. 24th one, background app refresh. I recommend everyone to consider this. To change, open Settings, then General, then Background App Refresh. Here pick the app that you require to get real-time updates as notifications. There are many different apps that you install regularly as per the interest. But only few needs to be run in the background, like email apps, Facebook to get incoming notifications, banking apps to get the transaction details regularly, etc. These apps will run all the time and checks for new emails or updates in the background, which will drain the battery. So you need to turn off the background app refresh for the apps that you don't require to get real-time updates. Using fewer apps will improve the battery life for sure. 25th one, sending last location. To enable it, open Settings, then tap on Apple account, then iCloud, then find my iPhone, and here choose Send Last Location option. If you misplace the iPhone somewhere else and can't find it using Find My iPhone feature, then Send Last Location might rescue you. When your iPhone is about to run out of battery, it will send one last location update to iCloud as long as it also has an active internet connection. Now let's talk about few privacy settings. There are about 3 major changes you need to do in these privacy settings. I don't actually need you to change all of these settings that I'll be telling you because developers need some data to enhance their app experience. It's up to you whether to enable or disable access. 26th one is advertising. Go to settings, then privacy, and at the bottom choose advertising. You can disable it if you don't want to share your interest with Apple. Based on your usage, Apple will show you the relevant ads in App Store or somewhere else. 27th one is analytics. To change, go to settings, then privacy, and at the bottom choose analytics. It's up to you whether to share the data or not. But personally, I turn it on because it will help Apple to improve its products or services. 28th one is location services. To change, go to settings, then privacy, and choose location services. At the bottom, tap on system services, and here turn off location-based Apple ads. 29th one is turning off the in-app ratings and reviews. To turn this off, open settings, then iTunes and App Store, and toggle the in-app ratings and reviews. By turning this off, you won't see any pop-ups asking you to review the app. Also, consider turning off the video autoplay in the App Store. 30th one is force restart. To force restart the iPhone X, all you need to press the volume up button, volume down button, and continue holding the side button until you see the black screen. The phone will start again by itself and here you'll see the Apple logo. That's it. 31st one is the recovery mode. To place the iPhone X in recovery mode, connect the iPhone X to the computer using lightning cable and press volume up button, volume down button, and press and hold the side button until you see the iTunes logo. Not the Apple logo, it's iTunes logo. Now the iPhone X is in the recovery mode. And the final one is the DFU mode. To enter into DFU mode, connect the iPhone X to the computer using lightning cable and press the volume up button, volume down button, and press and hold the side button for about 10 seconds. Once the time is up, press the volume down button by continue holding the side button and release the side button after 5 seconds by continue holding the volume down button. There you go. Now the iPhone X will be in DFU mode and you can check that with iTunes. To exit the DFU mode, press the volume up button, volume down button, and press and hold the side button until you see the Apple logo.
That's it for this video. I hope you find this video useful. If you do, please hit the like button and consider sharing this video with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos like this. If you have any issues, drop your comment down below. This is Praveen signing off. Hope to see you in my next video. Thank you.